Oh, welcome once again, hockey fans, and welcome to the Jim Ciccone Civic Center in Prince Rupert. Although it is a nice day today outside. Glad to have you along watching here on TSN, the Sudoon Network, on our new YouTube channel, Hockey Night in BC. Today's matchup has the Prince Rupert Peewee Reps, the Seawolves in white, going up against the visiting Smithers Storm, who made the trek all the way down here. And starting referee for today's game, Cam McIntyre. On the lines, Tom Hogman and Caden Melanson. It's going to be a good hockey game, Kevin, doing the color commentary, and Paul Cox on camera.
Yes, Mike. Smithers, as you know, in the past, they usually come down with a lot of skill. They get an opportunity to, with the weather up in Smithers, Mike, to play pond hockey. So they can stick handle in a phone booth. But they usually come with a lot of skill and good skating. I didn't have a chance to talk to the coaching staff of the Prince Rupert team because they're behind closed doors, keeping everything sort of hush-hush before this game on what their strategy will be against the Smithers team. Smithers Storm, beautiful part of British Columbia. As we're here at the Jim Ciccone Civic Center, standing room only. We got one big fan up there.
Get a shot of that one fan, Paul.
Yeah, there's a fan up there, one big fan. Courtesy of Mike Sidhu.
Our biggest man in the house.
Starting, it looks like the Rupert has one goaltender dressed, Thor Peterson, from the Norwegian national team.
Been better, yeah, way better.
And then Smithers in.
And they've got two goaltenders. They got number one is Isaac Brooks, and number 30, Emma Garcia's backing him up.
As both teams go into their pre-game warm-up.
So sit back, hockey fans. Crack open a cool one and maybe a sandwich. As these two teams get ready to do battle here today. I'm not sure how many times they've met already this season. Maybe you can shed some light on that, Kevin?
I think talking to the Rupert, I believe he's the general manager, Dave Harry Sinden Magnuson. It's pretty good competition against the Smithers team.
So they met in the past.
I believe they have, yes.
That should be a good game here today. And they play another one tomorrow. But just been told that game is too early for me. I don't get up that early.
Well, I think it's a 9 o'clock start, so you have to be in makeup around 5 a.m.
5 a.m., yeah. With a high def. You know that it'll show every crater in my face. And we can't have that.
Oh, the Smithers Storm Peewee Rep team is sponsored by LB Paving. And the Prince Rupert Rep team, Peewee Rep,
like that, both
all
teams.
West glass.
Yeah, and kudos to both sponsors for putting up the extra money to get numbers on their sleeves. It doesn't mean anything to anybody you sitting at home watching the game, but to me up here in the broadcast booth, it's gold having them their numbers on their sleeves. Because a lot of these kids like tucking in their jersey at the back, like Gretzky used to do. So you can't make out the number on the back. You have to look at their sleeves to get the number for each player. So the horn sounds now. We're going to start the game. Looks like maybe Emma Garcia might get the start with Isaac Brooks making his way over to the...
it looks like they got one goalie dressed as a goaltender, Isaac Brooks. And Emma Garcia might be playing. I'm just trying to check the numbers here.
Yeah, she's got number 30 on the list here. But it looks like Brooks, Isaac Brooks, going back to the net. He's going to get the nod here.
Yeah, I don't see number 30 on the bench right now, Mike. So maybe she was going to make the trip. But we'll confirm that with the game sheet over in the penalty box in between periods.
Puck back into Smithers' territory. Shot around the boards on its near side. Kept into the line by Jared McMillan. He's playing defense on this near side. Takes out his man along the side boards. Smithers on the attack now. Working the puck down low. Out of the corner is Charles Newman. Newman with the puck. Trying to stick handle through a phone booth. Can't do it. Turns over the puck. And Cooper Magnuson, the captain for the Seawolves, is over there as well. Trying to jar that puck loose. Puck comes loose to the defenseman, Brendan Kearney, number 29. He let the shot go wide. He stands up his man at the blue line. He's got it now. Brings it back in over the Seawolves line. Trying to throw it in front. Puck is picked up there by the Seawolves. Out they come through center ice. Led by Magnuson. Cooper Magnuson down his near side. Throws it in the high slot. Nobody there.
That's a nice little pass by
the captain, Magnuson.
Yeah, Magnuson, yeah, went with good speed.
Puck in the neutral zone, a battle for it. Ensues. It comes loose. Brought back in over the line by trying to figure out who number 7 is for the Rampage. He's wearing the A. I'm not sure if that's Brody Graham or not. Or is it Velman? Wearing number 7. Out come the Seawolves on the attack, led by number 19. Offside call, that's Brody Graham, wearing number 19. Just a sec.
Yeah, we'll just try to upgrade the... I'll go down and check, Mike. I'll go down and just check the... upgrade our roster here.
Yeah.
As we're missing a couple of players that were on the list that was supplied to us by the coaching staff of the Prince Rupert team.
And I went over it with two coaches from that Rupert team. And they looked at it, at our list, and everything's good. But it's not. There come the Smithers Storm on the attack, led by Ryan Richter. Richter's got the puck down that far side. He's got a man going to the front of the net. Pass is too far in front of Jared Fort. Fort trying to center it in front into the slot area to Caelan Parker. And away come the Seawolves through center. And they're stopped. Velman shoots the puck back in, number 22. There come the Smithers Storm on the attack. Led by Preston Pierce. Back come the Seawolves. Deep inside of Smithers' territory. Puck centered in front was Velman. And that's broken up there by the Storm. His stick handle neatly out through center ice. Puck played to the Rupert Lions. Magnuson plays it up the middle. Now the Storm have it again. Play a bit scrambling in the neutral zone. Both teams unable to make two good passes. Without it going the other way, and then there's a chance for the Seawolves again. Puck played the line, shot in by number 19, Brody Graham. Graham's got the puck now. From his own blue line. He hits red line. In over the Smithers line. Smithers working the puck back in their own goal, trying to come out of their own zone. Up through center ice. Picking up the puck is Bateman. Nicole Bateman with the puck on that left side. Trying to work the puck in deep. Puck centered out in front. Kept in there by Richter. Richter shoots it into the corner. Reversing the flow is Owen Davies, number 17. They jam away at it on the short side. Smithers coming close. For Pedersen jumps on a loose puck, hangs on. Well, Kevin, thank you for going down and straightening out the lineup for us.
Yeah, we have a couple of add-ons to the list. Number 2, Noah Kloppers, and number 7, Ryder Rochon. But a good job by Thorpe, Pedersen, and the Rupert net, taking the bottom end of the net away as the Smithers player was trying to jam it in there. He stayed strong, hugged the post, and made the good save to keep the score at 0, 15:07 left in the first period.
That Ignition takes the faceoff, lost it. Smithers have it. Back to come on the attack, a shot. Blocked in front. Back to the point. Deflected right in front. Thor Pedersen, he might have got a piece of that. Deflecting it just wide. Seawolves in a bit of trouble now as Nish lost the puck. Looked like she was going to skate it out into center ice. Good job by the Storm. Keeping the puck onside. Bellman has it. Bellman goes rink wide. Pass onto the far side for Alex Bowler. Bowler plays it back to his defense. It's picked off there by the Storm. There's a quick shot. Good chance in front. Off the stick of Damian Lowry. Damon Lowry. Letting that shot go. Having the goalie going one way. Turning it back to the other side.
Yeah,
puck shot into Rupert territory.
Good job by that line. Lowry, Meyer, and Jarzma.
Yeah, Evan Jarzma.
Yeah, keeping the Rupert hemmed in their own end. Had a couple of good scoring chances.
Rupert Seawolves on the attack. Puck shot in deep in the Smithers net. Now Magnuson with a couple of chances. Can't get it in front. Out come the Storm. Led by number 3, Riley Pedersen. Riley Pedersen takes it wide, throws it in front, gets his own rebound. And now Cooper Magnuson with a puck. Drop pass in his own zone for Brody Graham. Graham setting it up. What is it to his defense partner, Taya Shepard? Taya Shepard with the puck, reversing the flow, throws it around the wing onto the far side. Seawolves unable to come out of their own zone. Good forechecking here by the Smithers Storm as Kalen Parker is decked in front of the high slot. Puck comes out over the line and out into center ice. Rallying the puck back there is Carson Brooks. Dan Shepard, lead pass. Up the middle for Cooper. Magnuson couldn't handle it cleanly. And now Riley Pedersen with a shot from Wellum. Fired it wide. Magnuson goes to the bench on line change. Out comes Fresh Troops. Here's Vellman. He's got the puck again for the Rupert Seawolves. Takes a look, plays it up the middle. Good pass there for Riley Pedersen. Drop pass. And Vellman hustles back. He wasn't in position to take the pass. Vellman trying to move it up his near side. Couldn't do it. Gets another chance. Doesn't get enough on it. And it's picked off there by the Storm. Finley Reed up there forechecking. He's got the puck. Reed working his way back in the Rupert net. Puts on the brakes, backhands it out in front. And taking a couple of swipes at it was Charles Newman. Newman now hustling down to get after that puck. Puck is kept in at the line. Here's Bateman with it. Bateman let the shot go towards the front of the net. Here come the Seawolves on the attack. Taking a pass at center ice is Riley Mellis. Mellis couldn't do much with it.
Two big rangy defensemen on both, one on each team. You got Brennan Carney for the Smithers Storm.
That's
and on the other side is I still have him on my list. Magnus Veldman, big defenseman, left-handed shot for the Prince Rupert team.
Yeah. Cool. They're both looking good out there tonight.
Yeah, both can carry the puck and try to make that nice first tape-to-tape pass on their own end.
Oh, nice pass in front from Damian Laurie to Gabriel Meyer. And they just misconnected there. Good stick handling by number 14, Damian Lowry.
Yeah, Lowry, Meyer, and number 26, Jarzma, again, applying pressure on the Rupert zone.
Rupert, control or draw. It's Magnuson, back of his own net. Thing there from Veldman. He reverses the flow. They're trying to come out this near side now. Good play there by the Rupert Seawolves. Magnuson fires the puck in from blue line. Bounces right out in front. Took a Rupert hop off the corner boards. Cooper Magnuson fighting to keep it onside. Played it down low. Gets a return feed. Out of the corner. Plays it back to the point. There's a wrist shot. On the screen. Good save there. Made by the goaltender Brooks. But the last second. He was in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, nice shot. It was a screenshot from the point.
On a good chance, cutting in front was Ryder Rochon, number 7. Battle for it, into the corner, back of the net. Good job there by Riley Mellis. Back comes Smithers on the attack. Kalen Partner wearing number 88. He's got the puck. Puck played out into center ice in the neutral ice area. Rupert fighting to keep it onside inside of the zone. It couldn't do it. They'll try again as puck was shot in by Lucas Lindstrom. Lidstrom, number 18, playing on left wing, or right wing, left wing rather. Hustling back, trying to get in the play. Oh, there's a shot off the crossbar. Smithers coming close there, came off the stick of Charles Newman, number 4. He's got the puck into the corner. Newman trying to go back to the point, but it was intercepted there by his own player, Finley Reed. Now it comes back to the point. Good save there by the goaltender Peterson. Kearney, far side pass onto that left side. A good slap shot and a save made by the goaltender Peterson. That came off the stick of Pierre. Preston Pierre, we're number 17 on defense for the Smithers Storm. Trying to jam it in on the short side was number 7, Finley Reed. Puck shot in the corner. Finley Reed on it. Trying to put it off the boards. Gets a little bit of help from his wingers.
Good job by the Storm. They're changing as the puck is in the offensive zone. So a long shift for the Rupert team.
Glove saved by Thor Peterson. He hangs on. 7:42 left to go here in the opening period. No score.
Yeah, lots of pressure by the Storm. Creating a storm in the Rupert end. Rupert just has to try to get that puck and get it high off the glass. And just get it out into the neutral zone and hopefully try to get a line change. But a good job by the Storm adding pressure. And even though they're changing on the fly in the offensive zone, they still have control of the puck.
And Nolan Clauber. Clauber's with the puck. On this near side, fires the puck into the corner. Giving a bump as he goes to the back of the net by Ryan Richter. Puck played into the middle. Falling down was Damian Lowry, number 14. Puck now played out into center ice, into the Storm zone. Nice pass and play there from the defense up to the forward line. Taking the puck in the far side. Evan Jarzma on that far side. Battle for long boards on his near side. Picked up by the Seawolves. They'll try transition hockey. And firing the puck in is Brody Graham. Graham on the blue line. Giving a bump there in front of the net was Riley Mellis. Went to the ice. He's back on his skates again. He's in the corner now on the forecheck. Three Seawolves in that corner. Trying to work the puck loose. Puck comes up the wing. Good pass there from Gabriela Meyer. Ahead to Damian Lowry. Lowry treasures Savardi and spin around. Backhand shot, they score! From a sharp angle. Smithers get the goal past Thor Peterson. And it looks like Evan Jarzma, number 26, picking up the goal on the backhand. Sharp angle shot.
Yeah, good to rampage. Seawolves are on the... In the Storm's net, and they sort of got caught with their three forwards down deep to the near boards, and the Storm broke out on a nice 3-on-2. So the Seawolves have to make sure they have a little bit of a safety valve, but one of the forwards be on the defensive side of the puck.
Yeah, that was a nice pass, Kevin, from the wing. Gabriela Meyer. She made a nice pass ahead to Damian Lowry. Lowry got it to Jarzma, backhanded over top of the net, over top of the goaltender, rather, for Peterson to make it 1-0. 5:36 left to go here in this opening period. Clearing pass intercepted by the Seawolves. Drop pass into the high slot. But coming back was Richter. Got the puck ahead. It was Riley Peterson making that pass. He intercepted that Seawolves pass. He's got the puck again out of the corner. Riley Peterson. Puck shot wide in the Rupert net. Smith and Storm. Keeping the puck onside. And the shot went off the leg of Lucas Lindstrom. He goes right to the bench on the blind change. Replaced there by Noah Kloppers, number two. Puck kept in at that right point. Centering pass in front. Backhand shot just wide. Came up with stick of Jared Fort. Good play there by Brendan Tierney. Tierney, that's that one. Good by him, and down the icing goes. Icing call against the Seawolves.
Yeah, Graham, the defensive for the Seawolves, iced the puck. Too much pressure, he needed a line change. But I'm pretty impressed with the Storm's defensive, Mike. They've seen, for example, number five, Richter. He had the puck just below our booth here, and instead of dumping it back in, he reversed the play to the other side. So they kept puck possession, and without creating a delayed offside. So if you have the puck, the other team can't score.
Good eye, Kevin. Puck picked off now by the Seawolves. 2-on-2, but broke coming back hard was Richter. Richter goes to the bench on line change. Nicole Bateman trying to back and that pass in front. I got number four as Charles Newman, but it's, unless he's got long hair, I thought it was a girl.
Nicole, I guess the number two, the left winger there, Mike, Nicole Bateman?
Yes.
Maybe number four has got the flow going.
Oh, maybe that's what it is.
Of a player that used to play for the Penguins back in the day.
Yammer Yager.
Yes.
Yes.
So this period, so 3:40 left in the first period. The majority of the play has been in the Rupert zone. As the previous off to just tighten up on their defensive zone coverage.
Seawolves get the puck out of their own zone.
I guess if there's nothing there, you're coming down on a 3-on-2. If there's nothing there, dump the puck in and use your speed and your momentum to go in and go heavy on the forecheck. But this Storm team, they tend not to panic on the back end of the defenseman. They make that nice first pass, but Rupert just got to keep skating. And try to use your speed against the Storm team.
Here's Lowry out of the corner. Stick handling neatly, comes in behind the Rupert net. Comes out the far, this near side rather. Through the puck in front, broken up there by the Seawolves. And they come through center ice. Good back-checking effort there by Gabriella Meyer. Storm recover the puck, skated out into center ice. Led by Preston Pierce. Preston Pierre, rather. Puck now out into center ice. Richter makes a good play, plays it over onto the near side. For Preston Pierre. Pierre's pass in the middle, broken up. Seawolves have it. Puck is brought back in. Weak shot. Goes wide of the net on the short side. Came off a stick of Cooper Magnuson. Seawolves have it. Bring it back in over the line. Bellman throws the puck into the middle. Kalen Parker intercepted that pass. Puck played on the near side. He got by the defenseman. Jared McMillan. McMillan with the puck. Back in the net. He's decked. No penalty call on the play. Coaching staff upset. Arms in the air. Out come the Seawolves. Magnuson throws it into the high slot. Backhand shot right on. Good save there by the goaltender, Brooks. Isaac Brooks. He hasn't been too busy down there for the Smithers Storm.
Yeah, nice job. Took the... went into the butterfly position and made a good save with what looked like his left pad. The defenseman cleared the rebound.
Spin the Storm on the attack. Shoot the puck into the Rupert Seawolves zone. Puck is retrieved there by Brody Graham. Graham got it ahead. Out of center ice. Shooting the puck in deep is Brody Graham. Ryder Rashawn make that.
Seawolves are doing a good job forechecking right now. See, 20 seconds left in the first period.
Puck shot deep into Rupert territory. They fight to get it out of the zone. Smithers Storm now on the attack. Behind the net, Finley Reed tying up his man along the boards. He gets some help over there on this. Behind the net from Newman. Puck is dug free from by the Storm. Time winds down, and the horn sounds to end the first period of play. Kevin, it looks like they're going to flood the ice here after the first period. I don't know.
Maybe after this, between the second and third, or halfway between the second period. My stats say it looks like the shots on goal were 10-4 in favor of the Storm, and that sort of dictates majority of the play was in the Rupert's end.
Definitely, definitely.
Well, it looks like they're going to do the ice, so we can take a break. But the goaltender Thor Peterson did a good job in the Seawolves' end to keep the score 1-0 in favor of the Storm. We'll see what type of adjustments the coaching staff of the Seawolves do to battle against a tough forecheck from the Storm. And I'm pretty impressed with the Storm D-man. Like I say, they make that first nice pass out of their own end, tape to tape, passing the puck ahead, making the puck do the work. And they're not afraid to pinch in on the blue line to keep the puck in and get some more chances against the Seawolves. The Seawolves, towards the end there, they're making a couple of good passes out of their own end, tape to tape, and getting the puck. They got across the center line, they would dump in, and it would either dump and chase or dump and go on a line change. I see Lucas Lindstrom is behind the bench there. The training staff from the Seawolves are checking him out. He's walking with a little bit of a limp there. And he'll make his way to the dress room. And we'll get an update and see if he's got his left skate off, see if he's able to return for the second period.
Well, there you have it, hockey fans. First period action. After one period of play, the Smith and Storm lead it 1-0. Stay tuned for second period action coming up right after this. Welcome back, hockey fans. Second period's action underway here at the Jim Sconey Civic Center Arena. The team in blue is Smithers, the Storm, and they're leading 1-0. Kearney makes a good move at the blue line, backhands the puck in deep. Puck at the side of the Rupert net. Defense, we're getting a little bit crossed up there. Cooper in there as well. Cooper Magnuson on the back check. They freeze it, get a face off.
Yeah, good job by the Rupert goaltender to keep the stay strong on the post there and freeze the puck for a face off.
Puck onto the far side now. Centered in front off the stick of Jarzma. He's got the lone goal here for the Storm. Top shelf on the goaltender for Peterson for the Rupert Seawolves. Storm work their way out into center ice. Jarzma with the puck. Plays it onto the wing over there for Lowry. Jarzma picks it up, moves out in front on the backhand. Trying to slip that one through the pads of the goaltender for Peterson. No luck that time. 18:56 gone, or left here in this second period.
Yeah, it looked like Riley Mellis tried to shoot the puck around to the other side, reverse the play, and he fanned on it, and a heavy forecheck once again from the Rupert Storm created a scoring chance.
Here's Vellman, oh, through center ice, tries to throw the puck onto the far side. Over there for Mellis, he lost the puck, and it's picked up by the Storm, by the Peterson. Plays it on to his near side for Kearney. There's the captain, Kearney. Brendan Kearney at center. Plays the puck ahead. Pass intended for Jared Fort. Fort hustles it and gets the puck first. Lost it there to the Seawolves. And the puck is shot. Outside the line, brought back in by Kalen Parker. Parker works his way into the corner on the far side. Gets a little help there from Riley Peterson. Here's Vellman now with the puck. Vellman skates the puck to center. Gets the Smithers blue line, fires the puck in. Comes around a corner on the far side. Rupert making a line change. Out comes Magnuson, number 8. Magnuson. Back checking. Skating the puck out to center ice is Preston Pierre. Shot the puck in from well out. Seawolves getting another chance to move it out. Out through center, and they come Cooper Magnuson. Magnuson making moves. Gets in the high slot, lets it go. Oh, that one found the wickets. Through the wickets of the goaltender, Brooks. Isaac Brooks giving up that big goal to Magnuson. Cooper Magnuson ties the game at 1.
Cooper Keith Magnuson took the puck from almost his own end and skated down. Looked like maybe the Storm, the defense went back up too far to their goaltender, and Magnuson took a shot and scored to make it 1-1 with 17:25 left in the second period. I'm going to get an update. I don't think Lucas Lindstrom he's on the bench, but he hasn't taken a shift now. He took that slap shot in the first period to his ankle. Left ankle, and he's hasn't returned to action.
So Jarzma and Magnuson, the goal scorers in this hockey game. Rupert, big second period goal. Here's Taya Shepard making moves inside her own line. Played the puck ahead to Maddie Nisch. Nisch trying to work the puck out. Brought back in by Nicole Bateman. Cross-ice passes to Newman. Charles Newman backhands his shot right on. Good save there by Thor Peterson. Rebound comes out to the point to Richter. Richter throws it in front and goes all the way through. Comes into the corner on the near side. Taya Shepard on to Shepard ahead to Maddie Nisch. A little bit of help from Cooper Magnuson. And the puck is out. And hustling onto the loose puck there is Bowler. Bowler skates the puck. A little bit of water on the ice there. After the flood, puck just stayed right where where the water sat. Newman got the puck ahead. He gets it again, a return feed. Picked up by Velman. Velman throws it up the middle. Puck was picked up there by Ryder Roshan, number 7. Here comes Storm on the attack. Good pad save there by the goaltender for Peterson. Foppers goes rink wide. Pass ahead of Owen Bertie Skinner. Owen Bertie Skinner, number 11. Up there on the forecheck. The right-hand shot.
Good speed so far in the second period, Mike.
Looks like the Seawolves have found their legs here in the second period. Pass almost broken up there by Verdi Skinner. Puck is now back inside of Rupert territory. Cooper Magnuson throws it rink wide. Makes the pass onto the far side for Noah Kloppers. Kloppers ahead to Magnuson. Kloppers goes to the bench on a line change. Magnuson hustling back. Trying to take the puck away from Lowry. Puck played at the point. Picked up there by Preston Pierre. And now it's shot out into center ice. Kearney. Rink wide pass over to Jarzma. Jarzma backhands the puck ahead to Preston Pierre. He lets the shot go. Fanned on it. Velman comes over to pick it up for the Seawolves. Looks up ice. Plays it up the middle. Nice pass ahead. A speedy Mellis shoots it. Oh, and he shot it wide. Sent in on the breakaway. Nice headman pass from the back end.
Looked like he might have felt some pressure from Kearney, the big rangy defenseman for the Storm on the back check. Mellis heard some footsteps.
Good job by Mellis coming back on Meyer. Meyer lost the puck. Gabriella Meyer. Puck comes to the blue line and out. And away goes Mellis. Riley Mellis goes a bench on a line change after getting the puck into Smithers' territory. High clearing attempt off the stick on number 17, Preston Pierre. That was blocked by one of the Rupert players. I believe Alex Bowler might have blocked that shot. There's a chance now. Puck kept in the line by Pierre. Preston Pierre, number 17. Smithers doing a good job now, not allowing the Seawolves out of their own zone. High shot from Preston Pierre. Blocked there in front. Came off the stick of Brody Graham. Graham got the puck onto the far side. Bowler gets the puck out into center ice. Here come the Seawolves, three of them, three on two. Cooper Magnuson takes a wide. He poke check there inside the line.
Yeah, good job by Carson Brooks. Defenseman for the Storm, a poke check on Magnuson.
Play comes out into center ice. At center, led by Riley Peterson. Peterson comes in on goal. Oh, the shot just wide of the net. And Bowler picks up the rebound. Off the end boards on the far side. Skates the puck out into center ice and dumps it in. Seawolves making a line change. Bowler heading to the bench. Out comes Skinner Verdi. Verdi Skinner, rather. Puck now shot into Rupert territory. Back for it is. The Seawolves, they try to come out. Good back check in there by Jared Fort for the Storm. Puck played to the wing, but gets by him. Out into center ice, and backboard is the Storm. Inside their own line. Puck at the blue line. The Rupert blue line, rather. Rupert unable to come out of their own zone. There's a chance on the far side. Looks like Noah Kloppers tried to clear it out, kept in. Over there by the Storms. By the Storm, rather. Velman cuts in front of his own net. The smooth skating defenseman out to center ice. Brings the puck in over the Smithers line, working his way into the corner. There's a shot. Went, don't know where that went. Off side of it. Now the Storm get the puck out. Newman goes rink wide. Onto the far side from Finley Reed. Reed from an angle fires the puck just wide of the net. Puck comes in the high slot to Newman. The shot deflected wide of the net. Finley Reed trying to center it out in front for Charles Newman. Newman had lost and it skates. Finley Reed comes up with the puck. Takes a look. Here's Reed from the corner making a move. He made a move on Brody Graham, number 19, a defenseman. Charles Newman with his puck on the backhand. Newman. Tried to go back to the high slot. Puck kept in there by Gabriel Meyer. Now the Seawolves break out into center ice. Copper, rink wide pass over to Owen Bertie Skinner. Goes to the bench on a line change. Smith and Storm on the attack. They dump the puck in deep. Taya Shepard back onto the loose puck. Being forced center inside the line. Good job there by Evan Jarzma. Jarzma back in the net. Into the corner on the near side. On a short side save made by Thor Peterson. Good chance there. Come off on the stick of Lowry, number 14 for the Storm. Puck comes back to the point on the near side. Kept in there. Jarzma's got it. Jarzma tried to go into the corner. He's got it again. Skate off the left wing. On a good shot. A good save. Glove save by Thor Peterson. Jarzma doing some good work on the side boards. Got the puck into the high slot. Let that shot go.
Yeah, Jarzma, Lowry, and Meyer, the four line for the Storm, creating some pressure on the D, but the Rupert forward, the first guy, first person back has to help out the defenseman. He's got to go down a little bit deeper. He can't be too high. He's got to help out the defense and even up the numbers.
Well, there's a high shot from the point. Came off the stick of Preston Pierre. Velman with the puck inside his own blue line. Takes a look on his far side, on the near side rather. Now he's on the far side. Played the puck ahead. Puck comes off the stick. A Bowler. Newman with that shot. Missed wide of the net. Here's Velman. Lead pass ahead. Does Owen protect that? Looks like the injured Lucas Lidstrom is back in the game, number 18. He blocked a shot in that first period. And during the intermission, had to skate off. Looked like he wasn't going to come back. But he put the skate on. He's back out there again. Good to see.
Yeah, his first shift of the second period after getting injured in the first. So we'll see what the coaching staff on the Seawolves had to make a little bit of adjustment. Looked like they're double shifting Cooper Magnuson, the captain for the Wolves. So with Lucas Lindstrom, the coach is down there, will have a little chat with him, see how he feels after taking his first shift of the second period.
Here's Sloppers against the blue line. Fires the puck into the middle in the center ice. Shot down, kept in there by Caelan Parker. Puck's now played into the corner on the near side, around the net. Graham got the puck ahead to Sloppers. Into the middle looking for Cooper Magnuson. That's broken up there and back comes Storm. On the attack. Having the puck on that far side is Jared Fort. He goes in back in the net, centers it out in front. And a weak shot attempt was made there by Riley Peterson, number 3. Puck now sent in deep inside of Smith and Storm territory. And out they come through center ice. Picking up that lead pass and bringing it in onside was Jared Fort, who just missed a check on the side boards. Good save there by Thor Peterson off the stick of Riley Peterson.
Looks like we have a penalty, body checking penalty against Brody Graham. First power play chance for the Storm. 1-1 score, 7:37 left in the second period.
Yes, Brody Graham on the penalty box for the Rupert Seawolves. Smithers on the attack now, turkey on the table for the Storm.
We'll see what type of power play, if they're going to leave the two defensemen at the back end or do the diamond type power play. This is our first look at it, so.
Moving in from the point position to keep it onside was number 29, Kearney, the captain for the Smithers Storm. Kearney moves in to the right wing hash marks. Puck rolls off the end of his stick. He circles the Rupert net, takes a look, plays it into the high slot. That pass was intended for Nicole Bateman. She was tied up in the slot area. Puck comes all the way back inside of Smithers territory. Up to get it is Nicole Bateman. Bateman gets puck in onside. Rupert Seawolves now trying to move it up this near side. Puck was broken up there by Kearney. He let the shot go and they score! Over top of the sprawl goaltender, Peterson. He didn't even see that one. I'm not sure who got that. Kevin,
it looked like swipe at Newman. It. Charles Newman. Hello, Newman. A nice shot from the point. Number 29, Kearney, as he kept the puck in for on the defensive in the offensive zone for the Storm, close to us here in the booth. Took a shot at the net, and Charles Newman got the puck past Peterson to put the score 2-1 in favor of the Storm. It looked like a power play goal, Mike?
Yeah, it was a power play goal. Charles Newman gets credit for that. And that's two that have eluded the goaltender Thor Peterson over his head. That might be the book on him tonight. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see what the Smithers Storm do. They get one with a man advantage.
Yeah, sometimes Peterson will go down low to take the bottom end of the net away and hug the post. And so, like I say, the two of the goals have been top shelf on him.
Rupert now trying to come out of their own zone. Hemmed in there by the Smithers Storm. Back for Rupert is Riley Mellis. Oh, that was Flopper's number two. One of the late additions in this hockey game. He's wearing number two, Noah Coppers. It's Cooper Magnuson, shoots it wide of the net. They'll go to the bench on a line change with Coppers. Bowler comes out onto the ice. Puck played onto the far side. Richter over there to get it for the Smithers Storm. Puck knocked out of the air. Good hand-eye coordination by Damon Lowry. He's got good vision out there. In comes Jarzmont, lets the shot go, wrist shot, right on, rebound, corralled there by Thor Peterson. 5:02 left to go here in the second. 2-1, Smithers in front.
Yeah, Rampage are getting pressured in the back end there. And Future Rampage. But pressure in the back end, and Brody Graham had a chance on his forehand to shoot the puck around on his forehand, it's stronger, but he decided to go on his backhand. He didn't get enough wood on it, and that's when the Storm intercepted it and kept the pressure in the Seawolves end.
Here comes Bellman from behind his own net into the high slot. He shoots the puck. Nobody there. Puck goes to Bowler. Bowler trying to throw it in front. He's looking for Lucas Lindstrom. Couldn't miss him. Missed him, though. And away comes the Storm down that far side, led by Preston Pierre from the point position. He's in back of the Rupert net, digging for that loose puck, pokes it free. Bowler's got it. Here's Bowler into the middle. He was looking for Lindstrom, went under the stick. Controlling it now is Kearney. Kearney gets it ahead on the far side, and the puck over to Jared Fort, and now it's picked up there by Newman. Richter, or check that Riley Peterson, number three. Peterson got back in time. Puck shot the length of the ice. No Seawolves able to touch it. Goes for an icing call against the Seawolves.
Yeah, good rush by Riley Peterson, number three. Play defense for the Storm. LB Paving. Made a good rush behind the net, and I think he's the one who sort of went behind the net and he stopped and went behind the net, and a little bit of a delay there, and he gave him some time and space to make that pass in front of the net. Wingers or forwards, if they're defensive rushing up, if they can't beat the guy wide, they can stop and delay, and that'll give him the player a chance to make that pass to the late guy coming in and to create a scoring champion a chance.
Face off one by the Rupert Seawolves. Puck into the corner on his near side. Puck is kicked out in the center ice by Mellis. Goaltender down, plays the puck to the corner. Isaac Brooks. Here come the Seawolves on the attack again. Mellis shot, deflected, just wide of the net. Puck goes in the corner and backhanded up the wing was Richter. Newman. Right wing pass on the far side. He gets the return feed. He's checked there and immediately by Mellis, who got the puck out into center ice. Smithers doing a great job making at least three passes. That's going to be the difference in the hockey game, hockey fans.
Yeah, the Smithers team, especially on the back end, they're keeping possession of the puck, not dumping it in to create a delayed offside. Bring the puck back, pass it to your D-man, and regroup and go on the attack once again.
Puck shot down the ice by the Seawolves. Icing called against them with 2:26 left to go here in the second period. Rupert down by one. But they got to put three passes together, at least three. They can do that, coming through the neutral zone from their own end. They'll get scoring chances down the other end. There's one pass, and it's turned over. They can't do that. Oh, top shelf, Gabriel. Gabriella.
Yeah, trying to go top shelf.
Gabriella Meyer. Oh, man, she was trying to go top shelf, all right.
So maybe you're right. The scouting report on this goaltender in Seawolves net, Thor Peterson, is to go top shelf. Yeah.
There's Cooper Magnuson cutting in on an angle. Shoots it high over top of the net. Just like his dad said. He has lots of chances, but he fires it over top of the net like he's trying to get a field goal or something.
Louis Pisaglia.
Puck loose in the high slot. Gabriella Meyer in there, wide open, looking for a pass from Damon Lowry. He's got the puck. Damon Lowry, centering pass in front. Oh, and he shot it just wide. Jarzma looking to get his second goal of the game. Here's Lowry, shoots it wide. Puck comes off the end boards. Picked up there by the pinching defenseman who tried to feed Jarzma with the puck. It was broken up there by Taya Shepard. And check that, Maddie Neef, number 16.
Yeah, Lowry had a couple of chances there, Mike, in the slot to take the shot, and he decided to make that nice little pass.
He's unselfish, a good little hockey player, that guy. He's going to the bench on line changes now. Changed his mind when he saw the puck come to him. There's a nice pass to Gabriella. Meyer scored! Set up by Lowry. There it is, Kevin. You've seen it coming. This guy, he likes to pass the puck and distribute it around. He doesn't take all the glory.
A real gentleman play there.
Yeah. Nice pass to Gabriella. Meyer makes no mistake to give the Smithers Storm the two-goal lead.
Yeah, Lowry, like I said earlier, he had a couple of chances to shoot, but he opted the pass. That time he did a nice little behind-the-back pass right into the player, Garcia, right into her wheelhouse, and she beat Pedersen low to the glove hand.
That was a big goal, last minute of that second period.
Garcia.
18 seconds left.
Gabriel Meyer.
Gabriella Meyer got the goal, yeah.
Sounds like she would be from the Swiss national team, Meyer.
Yeah.
I think there was a skier back in the day.
Wound up living in Smithers, probably, because of the ski hill.
Yeah, connection there, but yeah, that was a good shift for that line. For the Storm.
That's a, I think they're the second line. They'll have to shut them down the third and get into the, get on the oranges. Coach Magnuson got to read the riot act between periods. I believe they're going to come out and flood the ice once again. Kevin, your thoughts after 40 minutes of play?
Well, it looked like Rupert came out and you mentioned that they came out and found their legs. Maybe they just came off a long road trip, you know, 6 games in 7 nights. And they had some scoring chances with Cooper Magnuson scoring a goal to put them on this, on the scoreboard. And, but then, like you say, you talk about creating three passes. You know, the first pass out of their end from defense up to a forward, tape to tape, and another one giving it to a guy who's in motion, so he can receive the pass with speed and then generate some offense and use his momentum to go in the opposing end.
We just haven't seen that in this hockey game so far.
Yeah, there have been some pluses for the Seawolves, but I guess the coaching staff, they don't have to panic. They're behind by 2 goals and they got a third period coming up. So maybe they'll make, they made some adjustments for their speed. So maybe the coaching staff will make some more adjustments how to, you know, the defensive zone coverage in their own end, and then make those 2-3 passes up and use, like I say, momentum, get into the neutral zone and get down and get into the Storm's end and get some scoring chances.
Maybe get Thor's Pedersen to stand up a little bit. Plays good down low, but the 2 pucks that have beat him out of the 3 goals were up high. So, well, there you have it, hockey fans. Stay tuned, third period action coming up right after this. Well, hello once again, everybody, and welcome back to the third period. Set to get underway here at the Jim Ciccone Civic Center Arena. Just a friendly reminder here, the Smithers Storm in blue. They lead it 3-1 against the Prince Rupert Seawolves in white. Puck drop at center ice. Storm control it. On this far side. Parker couldn't come in over the blue line. Puck back in Smithers territory. Played off the boards here. Riley Peterson with the puck. Peterson down the right side, fires the shot on the short side. Good job by the goaltender, Thor Peterson. Here comes Venman. Venman moves in, the shot wide of the net. Puck comes off the end boards to Mellis. Riley Mellis over there on the forecheck. Controlled now by the Storm defense, trying to come out of their own zone. Puck into the high slot. And reaching for it, puck, was the defenseman, number 9, Jared Millen. Or McMillan, rather.
Good play by the defenseman there, Mike Carney. He had a chance to backhand it off the boards. Instead, he took the puck back in his own end. A little bit of a recoup and then made a nice strong pass up. And Storm eventually got the puck in the Rupert zone.
Yeah, well, coach. Puck comes out into the neutral ice area, and back forward is Kearney, the captain. Kearney goes rink wide. Onto the far side. Looks like the Richter. Richter got it ahead to Newman. Newman tees it up. A shot fired wide of the net. Rebound comes off the end wall. Picking up his floppers. He played it back into the point position, looking for help from Taya Shepard. Shepard onto the far side. Hit the puck ahead. Now it's Floppers down the left side. Floppers with a man in front of the net. Looks like Cooper Magnuson picks up the puck out of the corner, drop pass there for Clobbers. DeMellis looking for Cooper Magnuson. He lets the shot go. Didn't get much on it. He didn't even make it to the net. Here comes Newman. Newman's got the puck down this near side. Puts the move on McMillan. Check that Graham, rather. There's a shot from Nicole Bateman. Bateman up there on the forecheck. Bateman doing a good job on this near side. Puck squirts free out into center ice. Getting a stick on it was Preston Pierre. He'll shoot the puck back in deep. Puck goes in back of the Rupert net, picked up by Taya Shepard. Shepard reverses the flow like a veteran. Fires it onto that far side. Pass ahead for Riley Mellis. He tried to go into the middle, broken up there by the Storm. Storm doing a good job there. Tierney. Far side pass over to Pierre. Preston Pierre fired the puck in deep. Got by Shepard. Shepard with another chance. Takes her man to the puck. Takes her man off the puck. There's a girl on girl. Shepard on Gabriella Meyer. Meyer in the high slot. We're number 16. Here's Riley Mellis. Pass ahead to the Cloppers off his skate. Shepard goes back after it, being watched by Kearney, the captain for the Storm. Trying to spin away from the check. Lost the puck. The puck came ahead to Ryder Rochon. Mellis picks it up into the high slot. He was looking for Owen Davies, sneaking in on that point position. Davies wearing number 17 in white. Cooper Magnuson ties up his man along the sideboards. They try to freeze it, trying to get a faceoff. Getting some help there from Matty Nish. Here comes the Storm with the puck out of traffic. That was the captain, Kearney. Puck is out into center ice. Picked up by Velman. Magnus Velman circles inside the Smithers line around the net. Trying to throw it into the high slot. He was looking for Ryder Rochon, number 7. Puck kept in over there by Richter. Richter lets the shot go right onto the goaltender. For Peterson, he gloves it and hangs on. 14:53 left to go here in the third period, Kevin.
Well, it's just a long time ago, at the beginning of one of the shifts there, you had Mellis, Magnuson, and then Cloppers. They did a nice little cycle job down here. It looked like a couple of your fan favorite players, the Sedins, down deep there. They did a nice cycle. But then Mellis and Cloppers got stuck on the ice, a long shift. Magnuson went off, and they got stuck on the ice as Storm, it was their turn to put on some pressure.
Cloppers fires the puck in from the blue line. Chasing after is Velman. Velman with the puck. Trying to get it loose. On that far side to Mellis. Too much water on the ice. As we just came back on the ice 6 minutes ago, roughly. Puck played up in the middle. Two players collide at center ice. Looks like Cloppers for Rupert and Nicole Bateman, number 2 for the Storm. Let's check that. Who was it? Number 8, Jared Fort. They collided.
I'm just going to see if the coaching staff for the Seawolves, if they're going to shorten their bench here behind 3-1 with 14 minutes left. I'll keep track of that. We haven't seen Lucas Lindstrom out there yet, so maybe he's favoring his left ankle. He blocked a shot early in the first period.
So he had to skate off behind the bench. We've seen that when he came back for the second period. Put a skate back on. There's a short side shot. Good save there by Thor Peterson. Shot came off a stick of Reed. Reed's in front. Takes an extra whack at it.
I think the referee might go over and have a little chat with Finley Reed as he took a chop at the goaltender Peterson, who did a good job on the rebound control there. The shot came from the point. Kearney took a shot, and the good job by the goaltender in the Seawolves set to control the rebound, create a stoppage in play.
Magnus Veldman gets the puck ahead. Puck played in the middle. Oh, they come out of their own zone. Chasing after it is Roshan. Ryder Roshan on the forecheck. He's checked there. Puck played in the center ice now. Veldman has it. It's a nice pirouette. Lost the puck, though. Back on the Storm. High shot. He score! Over the shoulder, the glove hand. Shot off the wing. Coming in on the right wing was number 7. Finley Reed. Made no mistake. Put it over the shoulder of the goaltender Peterson.
Yeah, nice shot. Looked like Peterson had trouble tracking that puck as Finley Reed took that shot. Plays on the line with Nicole Bateman and Charles Newman.
Did Newman draw an assist, Kevin, on that goal? Have to watch a replay to see that one over again. Jarzma takes the pass. He's away down the right side. Puts on the brakes. Trying to corral that puck with a toe of his blade. There's a shot from the point. Off the stick of Carson Brooks. It's blocked there by the Seawolves. Here they come out through the neutral ice area. Magnus Veldman working around Carson Brooks. Centers it out in front in the high slot. Good save. And dragging that pad, that right pad, on the ice surface was Austin Brooks. Out come the Storms now. Storm on the attack. Out through center ice. There's Damian Lowry brought the puck in front of the net. Good scoring chance there for Smithers. When they got a 3-goal lead, they almost made a 4. Is that line, though, that big line makes a difference. Oh, what a great save. Did that make it in the net? Was that blocked in front, Kevin?
It looked like maybe Veldman might have blocked that shot.
Yeah.
It was right in the Smithers Storm wheelhouse.
Yeah, this is in the Storm house of Meyer. We got the third goal, I believe, for the Storm. Looked like she almost got her second of the game. Nice setup in front.
And it looks like the Seawolves have shortened their bench, Mike. We haven't seen Verdi, Skinner, Lindstrom, or Buller out this period. So it looks like they're going with 2 lines as they're behind 4-1 with 11:26 left in the third period.
Yeah, that fourth goal was a big goal to give up. They had a chance coming in here with down by 2 goals, but now they're down by 3.
And in comparison with Smithers, they're just rolling all the 3 lines. Obviously, they're up by 3 goals. Sometimes you might say that's the worst lead in hockey.
Yeah, at the NHL level, it certainly is. But it looks like a stranglehold right now at this level. And they come on the attack once again. Oh, and a point shot went wide on this near side. Storm fighting to keep it onside, but it's poked out over the line. It's chipped over to the far side. Picking it up is Riley Peterson. He fires the puck into the corner. Comes around up this near side. Veldman, Magnus Veldman with the puck. Plays it up ahead. Got it to the Cooper Magnuson, the captain for the Seawolves. Magnuson got a stick on that Richter shot. Offside called at the blue line.
Yeah, Pedersen, his teammate made one little move at the blue line, and Pedersen tried to get back onside, stretching his leg. But a good call by Thomas Hogman, who's the veteran official here this afternoon's game. So I'll just keep tabs and see how long the Rupert team will go with 2 lines with 10 minutes left, 10:16 left in the third period.
Faceoff, won by the Seawolves, but controlled by the Seawolves themselves. You get the puck out of their own zone as we near the midway mark of this third period. Seawolves looking to get that second goal. There's a chance in front. Good swipe at it from Riley Malice. Malice with the puck. Won't allow Smithers out of the zone. Nice setting pass. They score! A nice setup from Malice. Over to Magnuson. He went top shelf. Made no mistake. Closing the gap to 4-2 with just under 10 minutes left here in the third period. Just fighting chance. Nice setup there by Malice, the architect on that play.
Yeah, Malice had a chance earlier on. He plays right wing as a left-handed shot, and he was on that side. The puck came across. He just missed it, but a good job by Magnuson pivoting back against the boards. A nice pass, like a Ovechkin type of position, Magnuson, and he got the shot over top of goaltender Brooks. But a good pass by Melis.
Smitherstorm looking to come back. Trying to get that three-goal lead back. Here's Meyer with a shot from Eleanor. Check that. Yes, it was Meyer. Gabriella Meyer, number 16. She can shoot the puck. Puck in the high slot. Oh, good pad save by Tor Peterson on the rebound. Malice in front of the net. Check that. Gabriella Meyer. Good chance there from the blue line from Brendan Kearney, the captain, as well.
Yeah, Kearney's doesn't hesitate to move in from the point to get involved with the offense. But two good saves by the goaltender, Peterson, to keep the score 4-2. In favor of the Storm.
There's the Storm running the attack. Jarzma into the high slot. Pass goes through a few legs. And now the Rupert Seawolves clear the puck down the ice. Off the stick of Owen Davies. And a penalty coming up to the Seawolves in the neutral ice area. And Smith Storm touched the puck. It looks like a who they call the penalty.
I think it's going to be on Riley Mellis as Preston Pierre had an opportunity to make that pass, but he decided to use his speed and carry the puck in, and Mellis hauled him down. As it looks like there's a little bit of a delay, who's supposed to go to the box?
Yeah, it looked like a delayed penalty coming up against the Rupert Seawolves, but it was the Storm that touching the puck down there. So the play should have kept going on, but he blew the whistle.
Yeah, to me it looked like Mellis.
A little bit confusing there.
Yeah, so Ryder Rashawn's going to serve the penalty. And
so Mellis got away with one.
Yes, he did. So he's still in the running for most sportsmanlike player with no penalty minutes. Storm will go on a power play with Jared Fort, Roddy Peterson, and Caleb Barker, I believe.
Well, that's going to be a uphill climb now for the Seawolves, as they're going to go shorthanded here. Smithers power play coming up. They got a 4-2 lead.
The two linesmen are having a little bit of discussion. I guess the coach from the Storm is questioning what.
Yeah, I heard him ask, we had the puck. Why wouldn't we be, the whistle's supposed to be blown dead. The play stopped when the Seawolves touched puck, because the penalty was being called on them. But good call by the coaching staff asking why that was blown dead at that particular time when the puck was touched by a Storm player. Nevertheless, the puck is sent down the ice, 8:16 left to go here in regulation time. Rupert trailing by a pair. Smith and Storm on the attack, overskating the puck inside his own line. It's Carson Brooks, number 19. Back comes Velman, Magnus Velman, from an angle. The shot right on, shorthanded. Good save by Brooks. Brooks.
Good job. Yeah, good job by Valman Unis straight to go to the outside. And it looks like we have a killing penalty for the Seawolves or Mellis. And we got Buller who's taking a shift out there up the forward line as the one of the two forwards.
He's wide open in front of the net, high slot, but he couldn't corral that rebound. It was too close to the goaltender, Isaac Brooks, who hangs on. 7:48 left to go here in regulation time. Smithers Storm in blue leading it by a pair of goals. Rupert with a penalty. There's a chance in front for Bowler. Oh, and a good chance. Good save there by Isaac Brooks.
Yeah, good job by Mellis. That's the second faceoff he's won for the Seawolves. But Isaac Brooks taking the lower part of the net away. Has the paddle down, pads down, made a good save.
Here comes Newman with Jerry on his left.
And Kramer on the left, on the right.
Puck shot back into Smith's territory. Back forward now is Preston Pierre. Pull up puck in the middle of Kearney. Kearney tried to stick handle it into the zone. But it's picked up now by Cooper Magnuson. Coming in goal, looking for his third of the night. And he shot it wide. That would have been a huge goal had he put that in. That would have made it a one-goal hockey game. You know, hopefully get another chance. Just like it, bury it. Magnuson comes back, plays it hard to Velman. There's Mellis. Or check that Kloppers, he couldn't get it out. He'll get it again. Reversing the flow this time. Gets it to Velman on that far side. Velman plays it off the boards ahead to Magnuson. Magnuson overskates the puck. Man comes out of the box. Comes right to the bench on a line change. Two on one ensues on that far side. Good save there by Thor Peterson. Here comes Gabriel Meyer. Gabriella Meyer takes a look. Plays it up back. To Carson Brooks, broken up, sent down the ice. Back forward is Richter. He puts it hard off the boards to Gabriella Meyer.
A little bit of a hiccup in our technical difficulties.
Yeah, technical difficulties.
But good, yeah, good job by Meyer. She realized she had the puck there, and she realized, hey, we're still on the power play, so she did a little spin, slowed it down, and made a nice little pass there.
Yeah, got it over to Carson Brooks. Puck shot down the ice now, and Jason Affron is Riley Bershon. He circles away and heads off to the bench on a line change. 5:27 left to go. Here in regulation time, Smith and Storm carry the puck out through center ice. Good job by Preston Pierre. And he let the shot go and he scores. Handcuffed the goaltender, checked at Thor Peterson to open up a 5-2 lead.
That was Preston Pierre, Mike, going coast to coast. And it looked like Thor was looked like he was too far back in his net. He didn't come out and challenge the shooter, take away the angle. But another goal that they went top shelf with 5:17, 5-1, 5-2 in favor of the Storm.
Yeah, this is now a 3-goal lead.
I don't think that was a power play goal. I think it was 5-on-5.
Yeah. Back on the Seawolves on the attack, looking to get back in the hockey game. 5 minutes left. Tall order on this smooth skating, well coached hockey team from Smithers, the Storm.
Good play by 88 Parker there. He had one of his teammates just 3 or 4 feet in front of him, and he made that nice little pass. Make the puck do the work. Pass the puck ahead.
Trying to jam it in on a short side on a wraparound with Roddy Peterson. Now come the Prince Rupert Seawolves. Firing a puck in from center ice was Velman. Nobody there forechecking. All four guys over here at the bench. I don't know what happened there. That play obviously didn't work.
They went on a line change, a full-scale line change for the Seawolves, as we have Skinner out there with Magnuson and Kloppers up front.
There's Kalen Parker with the puck.
Verdi Skinner.
Back on the Storm, two of them. Two on three with some speed. Looks like Riley Pettersson is going to break in on that far side. He's got the A here tonight. One of the letters, Carson Brooks wearing the other A. Brendan Kearney wearing a C.
Yeah, 3:50 left. 5-2 score favor of the Storm. We'll see if the Seawolves coaching staff will go back to two lines here late in the third period, or just roll the lines and get this game done with and regroup, because I believe they play again tomorrow morning.
Yes, it's a two-game series. Smithers are here. They play tomorrow again, tomorrow morning. Too early for this guy. Stay home. And watch some NFL football.
We're just, our cameraman here, Paul Cox, has now viewed that the clock hasn't been running the last 20 seconds, maybe.
Yeah, now they get it going.
But yeah, we can't do the game tomorrow, Mike. I think we're on our way to do the Vegas game. The Knights are playing tomorrow night. I'm going to leave shortly after this game and go stay at Caesar's Palace. Go see Celine Dion. Shania Twain.
Well, I like that Shania Twain. I'm not a big Celine Dion fan.
Parlez-vous français?
Tu dire bien des choses chez toi? That's the only line.
Is your mobile, Kevin? Est-ce que c'est pour un mobile?
We should do a French broadcast one day. That'd be hilarious. A lot of silence in that one. Oh, there's a chance there from an angle. Came off the stick of Gabriella Meyer. Here's Richter, Ryan Richter. Brings the puck in, offside call. 2:33 left to go. Here in regulation time. Deck stacked against the Prince Rupert Seawolves now. The clock being their biggest nemesis of the evening.
Yeah, I was gonna, with the 5-2 score, I was thinking maybe the Seawolf or the Storm would just dump the puck in and have a little bit of a light forecheck and sort of clog up the neutral zone, preventing Seawolves making those passes. Just protect that 3-goal lead. We got the big line of Lowry out there for the Storm.
Jarzma and Meyer. Oh, there's a difficult chance there in front. A redirect right onto the goaltender, Isaac Brooks. He had to hang on to that. And here's a chance for Gabriel Meyer. Moving in, goes 5-hole. Nice pad save from Peterson. Stopping Gabriella Meyer. She should have at least a hat trick here in the third period alone with the scoring chances she's had.
Yeah. Peterson gave her the 5-hole and took it away. I was thinking with a right-hand shot coming down, going top shelf, but...
Like Owen Nolan.
Peterson, yeah, point where he's going to shoot in the All-Star game and put it top shelf. Yeah.
I think it was on a Hasek.
But maybe because the goaltender for the Seawolves is a... catches with his right hand.
Right.
So he went to plan B.
Kind of threw her off, yeah. Face off. Now controlled out in center ice by the Storm. Bringing the puck down his near side. Riley Peterson. He's playing defense tonight, but you wouldn't know it. He's up there forechecking. Knocked the puck off Cooper Magnuson's stick. Working it in front in the high slot. Rupert unable to clear the puck out of the zone right to the goaltender, Thor Peterson. He hangs on to stop the hemorrhaging with 1:41 left here in this third period.
Yeah, the Storm is still pedal to metal here in the third period, up by a three-goal lead. Thor Peterson doing a good job keeping the score within that.
Ryder Rashawn lost the puck. Puck was sent down the ice into Smithers territory. Hustling and skating the puck out and shooting it out over the line. That was Preston Pierre, played a strong game on defense. I believe he's got one of the goals here tonight. Puck in the high slot. Oh, Magnuson robbed by Isaac Brooks. Big pad save. Magnuson had him down and out and beat. But that leg shot out, that left leg. Good pad save there by the Smithers goaltender. Here's Lindstrom coming off the bench. Puck shot now up into the bench and on a play.
Yeah, good job by Magnuson. He had to fight off, not physically fight, but the defenseman had him wrapped up, and Magnuson used his strength and got a stick free and got a shot, but a great save by Isaac Brooks. Again, using that left pad, Hossack style, down butterfly to keep the score 5-2 in favor of the Storm.
There's Newman up there with Bateman. Let's shot go high over top of the net. Reed Finley with the puck. Newman in front all alone. Puck comes back to the point, at the right point. Kept in by Richter. He lets the shot go. Deflected wide by Reed to Bateman. Back for Reed. Back of the Rupert net. 21 seconds left. Bateman, good pass back to the point. And there's a point shot. Hit a leg in front. That might hit Reed himself. Finley Reed. Pucks in the high slot. Here's Newman, backhander, shot right on. Good save by Pedersen. Puck played back to the point. Kept in by Richter on the shot, right on at the buzzer. Good save. As the horn sounds, they end three periods of play, and the Smithers Storm are full marks for their three-goal victory here tonight as they mob the goaltender. Isaac Brooks, who's forced, wasn't very busy, but he did make some pretty good stops throughout the hockey game, huh, Kevin?
Yeah, it's you know, as a goaltender doesn't get that many shots, he's got to still be in the game mentally, and he was there, and he made some pretty good saves for sure. And Thor, the goaltender, Peterson, he made some good saves towards the end there. Just some of the shots that they scored on him went to the top shelf. But he had a positive ending, I believe, Mike, to this game, the goaltender for the Seawolves.
Well, maybe they'll bounce back tomorrow, this team.
As Paul Cox, our cameraman, said, the Rupert team couldn't weather the storm here. And we've had a number of storms here over the how many years we've lived here.
Yeah, no doubt. In Vancouver, it's news when it rains. Not here. Rain and wind, hurricane force. It's not news.
But we can say hometown hockey. It was a beautiful weekend.
That's true. That's true. It was nice here the whole weekend. Surprised many of the hometown hockey crew. They enjoyed it. And I hope you hockey fans all enjoyed all the action. Here on TSN, the Sidhu Network. I'm Mike Sidhu, along with cameraman Paul Cox. And colorman Kevin Mobles. And we brought you all the action here on our new YouTube channel, Hockey Night NBC on YouTube. Hope you enjoyed it, hockey fans. Check your local listings for more. We'll be back with more hockey coming up later on this season. So long. Hurry up. Go ahead.